I think when we go into any situation, you've got the vision of what you don't want, right? The worst case scenario. Talk about money, running out of money. You talk about your kids, the kids end up in prison or something, right? Best case scenario is over on the other side. And the experience that leads to the best case scenario, I don't believe has anything to do with the worst case scenario vision. That we have to glance in the direction of what we don't want. I don't want this skydive to go badly. I don't want my parachute to malfunction. I don't want to land in a tree. I don't want to land on the top of a mountain. There's a long list of things that I don't want. But I don't avoid them by paying attention to that vision, by paying attention to the negative visualization process. And the way that I know that I'm caught up in a negative visualization process that's going to increase the probability of the worst case scenario playing out is my highest intelligence, which I find is right about here. That when I get super worried, when I find myself getting fixated on this prototype malfunctioning, right, that vision, or the formation tumbling, and it can get pretty crazy, right? As soon as I realize that that's the case, I feel bad in my body. I have to stop. And I think we all have this skill. We've all developed it in our lives in various things. When you realize you're in a negative emotional state, you're charging ahead with anger, right? Why do we get angry? Because we're afraid something's going to happen that we don't want to see occur, right? Do you agree?
Yep.
And so at the root of that is fear. The root of anger is fear, and there's an awful lot of angry people out there. There's a lot of depressed people that wished that they could be angry, but they're even below that, right? Depression is, I feel helpless. I feel lost. In today's economy, we keep sort of spinning out this rumor that the economy is bad and getting worse, and I don't believe it's true. That some people get into the door of the airplane, you know, with the negative vision, and they make it occur just the way that they expected. That self-fulfilling prophecy is not just a myth, right? We watch people succeed in the context of others failing. And I look at the unbelievable opportunities that we have right now in the world to improve the situation, to expand our wealth, to expand the wealth of fantastic organizations like this so that more good can be done. How do we charge ahead fearlessly with our vision? Well, we have to say, all right, well, what do we not want? Okay, let's not look over there because I know how I feel when I look that way. It doesn't seem right. What would be the alternative to that? What does it feel like when we are in a state of abundance, a state of success? When I got into the airplane in Monterey Bay with all the X Games cameras on, you know, every move that you make is being taken by gigantic cameras and they're interviewing you, you know, and we're riding to altitude, 118 countries are watching us. Imagine 118 countries are watching you. They don't even understand what you're saying, but they watch every move. And of course, if I screwed up, now this would be, this is history I'm making here. Who I am, in terms of my story, this is one of those steps of the story. I got myself pretty nervous, as you can imagine. I felt like a first jump student. All these people that I've been trying to help all these years, sitting in the airplane, doing the things that they do. So what does a scared person do? So physiological changes in the body, right? We have muscles getting flexed, right? What do your eyes do when you're freaked out? You stare into space, but they often will do the nervous eyes. Right? We see the students do that a lot. They're not even looking at it. They just do the paranoid eyes. They're looking at it. And they're breathing. What does that become? Right? You could create it in your body. If you wanted to feel scared right now, you could physiologically shift the bottom up messages to the brain. And this is the interesting part. This is the part that my psychology research has been sort of clarifying and verifying. That when people get into a negative physiological state, and they do the things that their fear suggests that they should do, like tap your knee before a test when you're in school, or pace around when you're worried, or breathe badly, or all of these things together. The thoughts that you have access to, the skills that you have access to, are not the same as when you're in the opposite emotional state. Am I correct? that we can, you, if you feel terrible, you can't have a thought of, wow, my life is great. I'm so lucky. Oh my God, I have the best friends in the world. This is, I love this country. I've been elsewhere. And you know, you don't feel lucky. You don't feel like you're celebrating the positive aspects of your reality. You can't see them because you're making lists of the negative aspects.
Is it scary? We're doing a scary ride right now. Right? So this ride is totally in the dark, so the camera's not going to work. But all these brave people are going to do it with us. It's going to be awesome. This is so cool. So you have to get on this thing. And you go down in the dark in the water. Right? I'm scared. You guys scared?
No.
You're not scared?
No.
Well, I'm scared. This is scary.
Me too.
Look how you have to go.
Oh my gosh. Better not, I'll come up and punch him in the nose. Not really.